river meets the town in Llanbadarn, pretty much. So that seemed like the place to start taking photos. I went down there, I think it was January, and I didn't really know what I was looking for. I thought I would be ended. I would take a picture of the bridge. There's a couple of bridges that go over there. There's a railway bridge, and then there's a pedestrian or cycle path bridge. And I thought maybe I'll just take pictures of the bridges. I'll take a sound recorder with me to record the water because I knew I was going to use sound, being as I was going to use my guitar. So I was going to bring back the sound of the river to see if I could emulate that on the guitar. That was my plan there.
It's January, and I've just been down to the river. You can see how grey it is. That's the grey sky, very diffuse. I thought maybe diffuse skies would give me fewer reflections. They do.
So I just took pictures of the surface, just shooting across the top of the river, and I was shooting across the top of that. Pretty boring, pretty average pictures, the kind of pictures that you'd think, yeah, they're the kind of pictures that you take of water.
No doing, it was rubbish. Rubbish pictures, but yeah, mostly rubbish. My boots, however, are full of water. And when that started trickling in, I was very much aware of it.
I wasn't, I was pretty nonplussed, so I walked up onto the bridge. It's out tourist season, I knew they weren't going to be driving up there, so I just went, walked onto the bridge and shot down. And the reason I shot down was because there are legs on this bridge, so the cycle path bridge doesn't have any legs. This one has legs that hit in, they sit in the water, so the water hits that and creates a standing wave, which was quite, well, if you've seen the slideshows, that's where I got a lot of those shapes from.
This is the cycle path that I use quite a lot to get to the river. I've been waiting for the lights. You can see it just peeping out there now. 10 minutes it took me to clear this. When I arrived here, it was all leaves, and that's wet leaves. Easy slip. Hurty, as I found out. Couple of months ago. Now it's clear.
That was the first lot of photos that made me go, oh, that's pretty cool. Once I had those shots, then I was interested in the water. So I just thought, okay, well, maybe I can get closer.
The best thing about winter is this.
So I stuck some extension tubes on my lens and I went down to the water again, and I couldn't see anything, you know. If you're that far away from the water and it's moving fast past you, you can't see any detail, you just see a blur. So I just put my shutter speed on pretty fast, and I tried to get sharp.
I was going down, it's about a year after I started on the river actually, happy anniversary me, and I'm trying to reshoot the area that I had started the project on, because I've got a better lens now, I know a bit more about what I'm looking for. I'm not entirely happy with, well, I'm not happy because the ISO is too high. Which means the quality is low. Once I stretch them up to a full size, geez, that car sounds like a bus. Anyway, yeah, you'll start to see the image degrade. So I want to shoot them on a lower ISO with my new lens, which allows lots more light in. But of course, you do need the light. Today, huh? That's where the sun is. It's not yet hitting it here. It's already 10 o'clock. So here, again. But the light's not here yet. Not yet. How long do you reckon? Half an hour?
And just set off a burst, just take some pictures. And as these images started to appear on the back of the camera, that was my first proper wow moment. I was pretty lucky that I was getting all this the first time I went down to the river. I wasn't expecting to get anything that excited me. I was like, okay, this is the kind of thing I'm going to be doing.
Low river. Summer now, isn't it? June, sort of approaching the middle of June. So low, this pipe here is actually like lifted out of the water. Well, you know, it's proud of the water. I actually haven't seen it this low since the project started. We've just had a serious amount of rain. The river is pretty high. But look at all that mud. Serious mud.
Some time writing music to go with that, just trying to emulate flowing water, so fast flowing water. I was trying to emulate splashes of light, splashes of water, you know, light shining off the top with deep sounds, rumblings underneath, boom, 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 that sort of thing.
It's been quite dry, really, very little rain, and also being warm, it's very warm. Consistently warm. No one's using much electricity, not just here, but across the country, so there's not much demand. So they're not generating. And so, low river. So
that's the place where I first got an idea for what I wanted to do, what kind of images I wanted to produce, and what kind of sounds I was going to do. But Julian Ruddock, the guy I teach with, and he said, why don't you just continue up the river, Brian?